Hi, my name is Karthik from Design School by Wpalgoridm. This video is a part of a playlist called Dynamic Content Plugin for Elementor, in which we discuss the endless possibilities with the Dynamic Content Plugin, which is specially designed for Elementor Pro. Assuming that you have both Elementor Pro and Dynamic Content Plugin, I've already talked about the PDF SVG converter. Well, the idea is simple. You can generate a PDF out of the data filled in the Elementor Pro form or the user submitted data of Elementor Pro form, and you can actually design the PDF for that data using SVG, using drag and drop, right? I've shown that in the previous video. You can check out Dynamic Content Plugin playlist and you'll understand what I'm talking about. Now, in this video, I want to discuss about the Elementor signature field and how you can display the signature in the PDF generated using SVG, and also I want to show you how you can do multiple page PDF or multi-page PDF using the same SVG converter. Let's see how that works. Well, the signature field is just like any other field in the Elementor Pro form. So within the form, I'll just remove this. I'll just click on add item and I'll have the drop down. And by the way, you need to have the latest version of Dynamic Content Plugin to have this signature field. Scroll down till you see something called signature, and I'll just call it sign, or the label for it will be sign. Also, I'll change the ID to sign to keep it simple, right? And now, as you can see in the preview, we have a sign field, and I'm actually on my MacBook. And you can use your MacBook trackpad or basically any other laptop trackpad to sign this form. I'll show that in action in a bit. So this is the signature field. And just like I showed in the previous video, actions after submit is PDF. And the code for PDF is this, which generates a PDF of this design. So this is the design that you get, or the design that we discussed in the previous video. You can check out the SVG converter video. We're just taking this a step further. So I just want my sign in a separate page. So here I'll just click on add item. So just like we designed our previous page, in this page, I'm going to have some text saying I have read TMC or terms and conditions, and then I accept the contract or whatever text that you want to put in. Terms and conditions, and I accept the, and I'll just click this. I'll just move this a bit. I'll copy and paste this. Terms mentioned in the contract, right? So I'll just have this piece of text. This is going to be my standard piece of text, and I'm going to copy and paste this once again. I'm going to have text onto the right side, and I'm going to say your signature below. I'm just going to drag it onto the end of the document. And here, what I'm going to do is just drag in a rectangle, but don't worry. Instead of the rectangle, we'll see the signature itself. Don't worry about the rectangle or whatever structure that appears here. So we said that the ID of the signature field is sign. So the token to get signature field will be form colon sign within square braces. So here's a neat little trick that you can do, or neat little cool thing that you can do with this SVG converter thing. So once I have this design, I'll just click on the rectangle. I'll just click on view. I'll click on source, and that will show me the source ID. So you can see that there's something called rect, and that stands for rectangle in SVG. So instead of this SVG 5 or SVG underscore 5, I'll just put in the token for the signature, which is form colon sign. And here you cannot use the square braces. And by the way, this is suggested by Giovanni himself. So once you put this token, whatever sign user signs on your document, the whole rectangle will be replaced with that signature. Well, you may not see it right now, but you'll see it once the form is filled. So I'll just click on apply changes. I'll just click on view. I'll click on source. Now I'll copy this whole code and I'll paste it in the second page that we just created. So I'll click on PDF. Again, I'll click on the second page and I'll paste the code for the second page, right? So the second page will essentially have this piece of text, and then this rectangle will be replaced by the signature field or the signature itself, whatever signature user has. I'll update this. Now I'll go visit my form on the front end. I'm gonna fill some data. I'm gonna say some text. And like I said, for the signature field, I'm going to use my trackpad on my Mac, right? And it just takes the input. I'll just click on save. Now I'll just click on send. And one more thing to note, that while using this online code method, sometimes it works. Sometimes you may have to just duplicate the text items, or sometimes you have to create a new text object using the text tool. It's a hit and miss. It's not really perfect, but it clearly works. So I just made this out and I pasted this code in the second page of the form, or the PDF code. So the second page essentially has this code, right? So whatever text that you see here, these are basically separate pieces of text or separate text objects. I just created separate text objects. I then pasted the whole code by clicking on view, clicking on source, got the source code, pasted it into the form page. I'll just try it out again. I'll reload this page and I'll see how it works. I'm gonna give some data and sign again. I'm using my trackpad. I'll just click on save. I'll just click on send. And the form was successfully sent. Now I just need to visit the location where my PDF is saved. Since this is a local site, I can simply browse through the folders on my site. I stored it within this folder, Elementor/PDF, and there's my PDF, and I can view that, and it actually has two pages. As you can see, I opened it in the preview app. You can see the first page has all the data. So this was from the previous video. I just changed the design a bit. And the second page essentially has the text. And then it has the standard text. And the sign was retrieved using the dynamic token. So the signature just appears in the contract. So this is a neat little way to get your contract. So these two new features are introduced in Dynamic Content Plugin's latest version. Make sure you update the plugin. So that's it for now. That's it for SVG converter of dynamic content plugin. It's really powerful. All we did was, by using drag and drop, we designed our SVG. We then got the whole SVG code and pasted it into the PDF extension or PDF feature of Elementor Pro Form, which is provided by dynamic content plugin. So based on the code provided, and while entering text in this, you can enter static text or you can use tokens. While using objects such as this rectangle object, you can simply replace the ID with the dynamic token like we did here, right? And without obviously square braces, within double quotes, you just need to put the dynamic token of the signature. So it's form colon ID, and the ID for our signature field was sign. So this was what we put in this SVG code. Then I took the whole SVG code, created a new page and put that in the new page. And that's why we got another page. I'll just show the PDF again, or let's actually create another PDF. I'll just keep this tab open. So it's within this Elementor folder in PDF. So this is our brand new PDF. And this is the second page. You can see that here. So page one, page two, we'll fill the data again and we'll test it again. I'm going to enter a different piece of data. I'm going to clear this out. And I'm just going to click send. Now the PDF will be generated. And there we have our brand new PDF. Again, you can see the data submitted is shown in the first page. And when I click on the second page of the PDF, it gets the same static text. I think we need to click on save and then send. Let's try that again. Or let's actually reload the whole form page. I'm going to enter another piece of text. It's not really perfect, but it really works. I'm going to do a different, I'll just click on save and I'll click on send again. The form is sent. So this is my latest form. I'll view the second page and there's our latest signature. So it's always a good idea to reload the page after submitting, or you have to click on this clear button to clear this sign off. Or it's always better to reload the page and submit another piece of data if you want to. Either way, so that's the signature field, and that's how you get signature field and put it into your PDF design, right? So this was actually supposed to be a rectangle, but since we replaced the ID of the rectangle with the dynamic token, we got the dynamic data, which is the signature itself. Really neat, right? That's it for now. I'll catch you in the next video. And there are tons of features released in Dynamic Content Plugins latest version. We'll discuss all of them in the next video. Until then, take care. Goodbye.